Many, many years ago, there was a dear little girl named Goldilocks. Although she loved her mother and father very much, little Goldilocks was very curious and kept wandering away from home. Her mother had said, "Goldilocks, you must stay in the yard. Your father and I would be very worried if we looked for you and couldn't find you." Her father had taken her on his knee and warned her time and time again of all the wild animals in the woods that might chase her and frighten her to tears. But one day, Goldilocks' curiosity got the better of her, and she wandered off into the woods. She suddenly found that she had lost her way. Then up ahead of her, she saw a teeny wee house, and she said to herself, "Maybe some kind people live there, and they'll show me the way to go home." So she went up and knocked on the door. She knocked and knocked again and again, but nobody came to the door. After a little while, she began to get very, very hungry. So she tiptoed into the house and went into the dining room, and there, what do you think she found? Oh, look! 3 bowls of porridge! A big bowl, a medium-sized bowl, and a dear little teeny-weeny bowl. She had taken a taste of the porridge in the big bowl. Oh, that's too hot! Then she took a taste of the middle-sized bowl of porridge. Oh, that's too cold! So she tasted the porridge in the little teeny-weeny bowl. This is just right. And so, she ate it all up. Tired from the long walk, Goldilocks looked around for somewhere to rest. She came upon 3 chairs, a big chair, a middle-sized chair, and a teeny-weeny chair. The big chair was too tall. The middle-sized chair was too wide. But the teeny-weeny chair was just right. So she plopped herself down a little too hard and the chair broke into pieces. Well, by now, Goldilocks was so sleepy. She went into the bedroom and there she found 3 beds. A big bed, a middle-sized bed, and a dear little teeny-weeny bed. The big bed was too hard, and the middle-sized bed was too soft. So Goldilocks climbed into the teeny-weeny bed and was soon fast asleep. But while she was sleeping, the people who lived in the little house came home, and what do you think? They weren't people at all. They were 3 bears. Papa Bear, Mama Bear, and the little baby bear. And were they surprised to find someone had been eating their porridge? And the 3 bears said,
"Someone has been eating my porridge."
Someone has been eating my porridge too.
Oh, somebody's been eating my porridge and ate it all up.
So the 3 bears started looking around the house.
Someone has been sitting in my chair.
Someone has been sitting in my chair, too.
Oh, someone's been sitting in my chair, and it's broken to pieces.
Finally, they got to the bedroom, and they said,
Someone has been sleeping in my bed.
Someone has been sleeping in my bed, too.
Oh, somebody's been sleeping in my bed. And here she is.
Their voices awakened Goldilocks. She jumped out of the bed and ran out of the house. The bears were concerned for the little golden-haired girl. And Papa Bear called out to all the woodland creatures, asking them to help Goldilocks find her way home. When she arrived, she climbed into her mother's arms and said,
"Oh, Mother, Mother, I got lost and I was so afraid.
afraid and lonely. I'll never, never wander out of our yard again. And that is the story of Goldilocks and the Three Bears.